if just to watch a person using you, deep enough and strong enough using you, long enough and hard enough before you knew it, someone else would think. If he can do it, I can do it.
Sometimes I'm confused. Sometimes I can't sleep.
Sometimes all I can do is sleep.
Sometimes I want to scream.
Sometimes I just want ice cream.
I need to talk.
I don't want to talk.
I need a hug.
Please don't touch me.
I just need you to sit with me.
I just need to be alone.
I need your help.
I don't want your pity.
I need to do this my way.
Christina saw our thread on Instagram. She was so humiliated and devastated that she went home and took a bottle of her mother's pills.
The last comment on the thread was from Christina, and it said, "I can't believe that you guys would do this. I thought you were all my friends. It doesn't matter anymore now. I forgive you.
I wish I could forgive myself.
As years went by and months they drew her room, depression made her house feel like a tomb. Dad picked up the bottle and I picked up the broom.
Number one, we have a 1 week supply of painkiller. Behind curtain number two is an oldie but a goodie, marijuana. Behind curtain number three, we have the hottest drug here on the market on Staten Island, heroin.
You thought you were winning a prize, didn't you, Sam? But there's no prizes here in the heroin game, just curtains.
I was angry at Robert, angry at myself.
I was angry at the camp and at the guy who took advantage of me.
And so we started to list all the things that we could do with our anger, and the first thing I thought of was finding Robert and messing him up really bad.
Yeah. Or breaking the windows in his house.
Or slashing his tires.
Or taking the anger out on someone else, like my family or my friends.
Or myself. So what can we do with our anger that wouldn't hurt ourselves or anybody else?
She said we can organize speak outs, where we would tell other girls what happened to us.
We kept thinking of ways that we could channel our anger into action.